श्रीचिद्भिरवणेशान मोहय्यम सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपी अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धिदुर्गत्य निर्मलं अपारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक् परं महः तदेवाहं नमस्तोऽन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। ब्रह्मण विदाति पूर्व वेदांश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंह देवमात्म बुद्धि प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। शांति शांति शांतिः। Okay, so in the fourth chapter, the Guru Shishya Samvada, Tattva Drishti has asked questions, some question, and the Guru has answered. Now Tattva Drishti has a question further as to In the same question, the Guru is continuing. Ajnasya vishaya pravruttau satyam tadiya antar mukhavruttau atma anando bhati vishayeshu nasti ananda iti samadhanam. The ananda is not in vishaya, but when there is a pravrutti seeking ananda in the vishaya, the ananda lesha of the atma itself manifests when the desire towards the vishaya goes away on attaining the vishaya. For the ajna, For a jnani, the vishaya pravritti itself is mithya. Anyway, we'll see that further. So then in the end, what we saw is tataha vishayantara ichchaya punarapi buddhye chanchalye sati tasyam buddho swarupananda pratiphalanasya vichhedat puratayo sati api प्राचीन विषय न आनंदानुवृत्ति। हैड देर बीन विषय सुख, जस्ट गिव मी वन मोमेंट। ओके, सो सॉरी, पुरतेव सति अपि प्राचीन विषय, द अर्लियर विषया विच ब्रॉट अबाउट आनंद, दैट डज नॉट कंटिन्यू टू गिव आनंद। देर इज नो अनुवृत्ति ऑफ आनंद फ्रॉम द अर्लियर विषय, प्राचीन विषय, इवन इफ इट इज एक्सेसिबल। व्हाई? बिकॉज द डिजायर इज नो लॉन्गर देर फॉर दैट विषय विच इज रिजॉल्व्ड। इंस्टेड व्हाट हैज हैपेंड इज दैट द न्यू डिजायर हैज क्रॉप्ड अप, विषयांतर इच्छया, ड्यू टू अनदर अन्य विषय इच्छा, अगेन बुद्धि बिकम्स चंचला। वंस द बुद्धि हैज बिकम चंचला, विचेवर इज द विषय यू हैव, दैट वोंट लीड टू आनंद। द आनंद ऑफ द आत्मा विच इज स्वरूप आनंद, वंस ओन स्वरूप आनंद डज नॉट मैनिफेस्ट एनी मोर बिकॉज इट इज ब्लॉक्ड बाय अनदर विषय इच्छा। तस्मान्न विषये विषये अस्ति आनंदः, दिस मच वी हैव सीन। देयरफॉर आनंद इज नॉट देयर इन विषया, दिस इज द कंक्लूजन। किंच मोरओवर यदि नियमेन विषयाधीन एव आनंदो भवेत् तदा समाधौ योगानंदः न प्रकाशेत। योग हि चित्तवृत्ति निरोधः, विषय इच्छा एंड एनी विषय आनंद, हैड इट बीन ट्रू हाइपोथेटिकली, इफ विषय आनंद were truly there, was to be truly there, Vishayananda means what? Ananda, had there been Ananda in Vishaya, due to Vishaya even, then the vritti that takes place in Vishaya will lead to Ananda. If that is the case, in Yoga, Samadhi, Yoga Chitta Vriddhi Nirodha, Ashtanga Yoga leading to Samadhi, basically earlier are the training angas, and in the end, Dharana Dhyana Samadhi, the Antaranga Sadhana, there the definition of yoga is Chitta Vritti Nirodha. Then this Vishaya Vritti which is there, which the Purva Pakshi is claiming to be the source of Ananda, the Vishaya being the source of Ananda, Vishaya Vritti has to be there for Ananda Bhoga. Vishayananda Bhoga, then in Yoga, meaning Chitta Vritti Nirodha, where all Vishaya Vrittis are cease to be, not are, but when, where all Vishaya Vritti cease to be due to Nirodha, then where is the possibility of Ananda there? But in Samadhi, where Chitta Vritti Nirodha is there, that time there is Ananda. In fact, that Ananda is superior to any Vishayananda, all Vishayas put together. So, yadi niyamena, if you make such a rule that Vishayadhina eva Ananda, Ananda is dependent on the Vishaya, then tada, bhavet tada, samadhav yogananda na prakashita. There wouldn't be yogananda, yoga janya ananda, chittavritti shunyatvam. Where there is chittavritti shunyatvam, that kind of yoga janya ananda wouldn't be there. Chittavritti Nirodha Janya Ananda wouldn't be there. It wouldn't manifest, but it does. And what does the Tippanakara say? Tippanakara has a comment on Yoga Ananda. Chittekagrata Rupa Yogavi Vyangya Ananda. That Ananda which is manifest due to Chitta Ekagrata. Ekagrata is what? Dharana. And then dharana, dhyana, samadhi. That is the step. So, chitta, ekagrata, rupa, yogavi, vyanga, ananda. Then the starting from dharana, landing on samadhi, all the stages will give little ananda and finally samadhi will give immense ananda. That ananda which is manifest wouldn't be there. That is said in the mula and the comment on that yoga ananda shabda in the tippana. Tatha shushuptau api na ananda bhanam syat. Okay, I do not have samadhi experience. Samadhi anubhava lacking, how do I understand what is being said? So it is of theoretical value to me. Academic interest, nothing more. But then, I cannot say that I don't have sushupti anubhava. Sushupti anubhava is there for every prani also. Thereby, tatha shushuptau api na ananda bhanam syat. Ananda bhanam na syat. But there is ananda bhana for each and every person in shushupti. Shushupti samadhyor drushyarupa vishaya sambandhasya abhavat. Because in, just like in samadhi, in shushupti also, there is drushyarupa vishaya sambandhasya abhava. There is abhava, there is absence of any association with any kind of vishaya which is cognizable. Shabda sparsha rupa rasa gandha drishya is upalakshana, not only for drishya vishaya, but it is indicative of all that can be cognized through the sense organs using the antakkarana. Tasman vishaya ananda leshopyasti. Therefore, there is not even a bit of ananda sukha in any vishaya. Tippanakara says there, why sushupti is mentioned? Sushupti drishtantastu sarvajana prasidhyartam. Everyone knows this. Samadhi experience is rare, but then Shushupti Anubhava is there for everyone. Thereby, Shushupti example is also given to show there is not even a Sukhalesha in Vishaya. Kintu Atma Swarupa Ananda Eva Sarvatmana Sarvatra Obhasate. In whichever Vishaya, whosoever has Ananda Vritti, that Ananda Anubhava is only due to one's own Swarupa Ananda. Swarupa Ananda Eva Sarvatmana Sarvatra Obhasate. That Swarupa Ananda, how is it existent? It is existent in each and every person, individualized entity, as one's own self. Sarvatmana Sarvatra Obhasate, and it is there everywhere because it is an all pervasive tattva. Although it manifests in each and every being as myself, I am it. But still, it is there as a single entity which is all pervasive. Why so? Because Shruti says, Raso vaisaha rasagyam hevayal labdhva anandi bhavati etasyeva anandasya anyani bhutani matram upajivanti ityadi shrutehe. So, Shruti statements are quoted. Taittiriya Upanishad says, Raso Vaisaha. that atma is rasa, rasa rupa. Rasa, general meaning is taste, but then it is ananda. Rasa is ananda. So that atma, saha atma, rasaha, meaning anandaha, ananda rupena vartate. That is the idea there. Indeed, it is so. And when you say ananda, atma is ananda. Atma's lakshana is ananda. Satchit ananda, atma. Or in Taitra, it starts with satyam jnanam anantam brahma. And that brahma is atma. Finally, in the analysis, we see that that brahma is atma. That atma is ananta. And also elsewhere, ananda. Anantyam leads to ananda. Because when you are ananta, when you understand the ananta sarupa of atma, there is no objectification of something. There is no possibility of objectification because there is no object outside. You cannot even be called as subject anymore. There is nothing to be witnessed. There is nothing to seek. You cannot be called as a witness or a seeker anymore. So you are, what you really are is Ananda Swarupa, because every bit of seeking is already attained. Whatever you are seeking, you are already that because you are Ananta. Therefore, what you are really seeking through all pursuits is Ananda. And that comes to a full stop because you are Ananda Swarupa. Anantyam is leading to Ananda. If someone tells you you will be Ananta, but you will be Ananta Dukkha Rupa, nobody wants it. Everyone wants Ananda Swarupa. And that you really are. In Anantyam, there is Ananda hidden there. So, Raso Vaisa, that Ananda Swarupa is Atma, says the Taittiriya Upanishad. And then, Rasam, Rasam, he eva ayam labdva. Ayam Rasaha. Ayam Rasaha, ayam is earlier Saha. Saha can be Brahma. Tat Padartha. But eva ayam, when you say ayam, ayam is here and now. It is not drawn out in Desha Kala. Therefore, ayam saha brahma, saha is paramatma. Saha paramatma or saguna brahma. In neuter, the saha is said as atma really, but saha if you take paramatma. That paramatma is, first this saha is a little outward because there is a panchakosha viveka when one lands here in this atma tattva in Taittiriya Upanishad. Then eva ayam, very close. How close? Not separable from oneself because it is one's own swarupa, oneself. That self having attained labdva, how? By not attaining anything else, not seeking anything else, knowing that you are already the sought. Thereby, labdva, this attainment is figurative. Ayam labdva anandi bhavati. Why? Because raso vaisaha. Rasam hi eva ayam labdha. Ayam rasam labdha means this ananda swarupa atma rasa labdha anandi bhavati. And that attainment has to be figurative because ananda asya asti iti anandi, that in pratyanta, although it is ananda asya asti iti anandi, still that ananda asya kasya, asya der shashti is raho shiravat shashti. Rahu is the Shira. There is a name given to Shira as Rahu. So, Rahu ho Shira. When you say Shira of Rahu, that statement literally is meaningless. Figuratively, it makes sense. It is not the head of Rahu. The head is Rahu. Similarly, here, Ananda asya asti anandi bhavati means this Ananda is one's own swarupa. Then why do you have Vishayananda, which is the objection or the question raised by Tattva Drishti? There the answer is there in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. This Atma Ananda, Etasyeva Atmanaha Anandasya Anyani Bhutani Matram Upajivanti. A little bit is manifest in each and every being, and each and every, actually bhutani, there can be objects also. You can understand as where in a vishaya, why do you have sukha? Because there is ananda lesha there, that itself manifests. There is no other ananda. When you define, when it is defined as satyam jnanam anantam, and ananta leads to ananda, meaning by Lakshana, you know that it is Ananda, then that Ananda being the definition of Atma, wherever there is Ananda, it has to be the Atma Ananda. Otherwise, the definition will not hold. You cannot have a definition where, what is the definition? What is the Lakshana there? Lakshana is where the Lakshana attribute, Lakshana Visheshana. It is not Visheshana which is qualifying, okay? It is not a qualifying adjective. It is a defining adjective. That definition, that attribute or adjective that you see, not attribute, it's not an attribute, it's an adjective used not to differentiate, but it is to define. That defining adjective shouldn't be found elsewhere. That is a defining adjective. So if you say Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, then wherever there is existence, Satta, that is the Brahma Satta. Wherever there is Puranam, Chaitanyam, Jnanam, that is all Brahma Jnana, Brahma Satta, Brahma Chaitanya, Brahma Spuranam. Wherever there is Ananda, that has to be the Brahmananda, Atmananda. That is the idea of defining. And when Shruti has defined it, then wherever there is Anandasya Upajivanam, then that Ananda has to be the Atmananda. Ityadi Shruti. This is the Pramana for Vishyananda to be Mithya. And any Vishyananda being the manifestation of Atmananda. He Shishya, Niratishya Ananda Swarupa Eva Atma Iti Vishya Sambandhaccha Anando Abhivyajyate Iti Cha Janihi. So may you know that all Ananda which is manifest in Vishaya, when there is the Jiva and Vishya Sambandha through the Indriya, which is really Indriya Vishya Sambandha, that Ananda which manifest in the Antakarana, which is experienceable happiness, that is Niratishaya Ananda Swarupa Eva Atma. That Atma Swarupa being Niratishaya Ananda, that itself manifests. Sa Anandaha Abhivyajyate. It manifests. It manifests due to the Vishaya Sambandha, because the Kama towards the Vishaya goes away, and then the buddhi, chanchala buddhi becomes sthira, and then it is manifest. Ananda is manifest. Adrishyo drishyate rahur grihitena yathenduna tatha anubha matratma drishyenatma valokyate iti smritehe. There is a smriti statement also giving an example of Rahu. Who is Rahu? So we have Rahu and Ketu. Rahu is the shira visa, shiras, and rest of the body is Ketu. Now, in the astronomy and astrology, Jyotisha Shastra, Rahu is Adrishya really. People who have not studied Jyotisha, they have, you know, heard from some criticism of Jyotisha Shastra. They say that Rahu and Ketu, there are no such planets. But then people do talk about it. It is all nonsense. These people are illiterate really, those who comment on it, because Rahu and Ketu, how they are used in the Jyotisha Shastra, they do not know. Rahu is what? Adrishya Rahu. It has already said, the Smriti says Rahu is Adrishya. In fact, each and every Devata and Asuras are Adrishya to human beings right now. Even the planets which are far away, they are Adrishya. But Rahu, Ketu cannot be seen even using the telescope, because they are Adrishya in that sense, but they are called as shadow planets. Chaya Graha. Jyotisha Shastra does not say it as a Graha in the senses of other Grahas. It is a Chaya Graha. Adrishya Drishyate Rahu Yatha Induna Grihitena Induna Yatha Adrishya Rahu Drishyate Tatha. Example given is Rahu, who even being Adrishya, how do you understand Rahu? How do you see Rahu in the Jyotisha Shastra? Yatha grihitena induna. Because there is a Rahu and Ketu, Rahu and Ketu came into being because the Asura's head was cut off while trying to step in Amruta faking his himself to be Devata. And Surya and Chandra had complained. Therefore, Rahu and Ketu, in the story, in the Purana Katha, it has said that therefore Rahu and Ketu trouble the Surya and Indu. Indu is Chandra. They trouble these stars and planets because of this complaint, because of which they lost their, lost that Asuratvam and then got split into two. The head was cut off. So they are committed to cause eclipses. This is how eclipses are explained. The grahanas. So grihitena Induna. When there is a grahana of Indu, Surya grahana, or here example of the Chandra grahana. When there is a Chandra grahana, Chandra is not seen. Now why is Chandra not seen? Oh, there is a shadow of earth. Whatever, is there a shadow? Now that shadow is called as the Rahu here. That shadow planet, it is a shadow planet. Therefore, Rahu is known, Drishyate. Not literally seen, but Rahu is inferred. Oh, I see Rahu. How do you see the shadow? Yeah, that is Rahu. We give a name. There is a name given to that shadow as Rahu. Rahu Ketus are shadow planets in that manner. So, Adrishya Api Drishyate. Do you see the shadow? I don't see the shadow when I am looking at myself. Similarly, when you are looking at the moon, there is no shadow. But when there is an eclipse, the moon is eclipsed, and through that eclipse moon, you know the Rahu because you know the shadow. Tatha anubhava matratma drishyena atma avalokyate iti smrute. Iti smrute he. Smriti says that similarly, tatha, this atma is never seen. Existent but never seen. But then atma va are drashtavyaha shrotavya mantavya nididhyasitavya. So the means is shravana manana nididhyasana for atma darshana. And what is that atma darshana? Avalokyate anubhava matratma drishyena. What is that anubhava matratma drishyena? Anything that is drishya. In each and every drishya mithya vishaya atma anubhava is present. There is no separate atma anubhava. Wherever there is a vishaya anubhava, there itself atma anubhava is there. Because aham is pervading through and through. Atma anubhava is pervading through and through, making that anubhava of each and every vishaya possible. Without which it wouldn't be possible. Without which satta of the vishaya would not be possible, let alone anubhava. So that atma is also adrishya, because adrishya in which sense? As an object adrishya. If we try to objectify the atma, cannot be objectified because it is the very objectifier. But it is not the vishaya known through the vishaya. The vishaya manifests, that is what is said here, that atma vishaya ananda which is there, that is atma ananda abhivyanjanam. Just like the light, sunlight is not seen. What you see is the light, but it is the reflected light. It is not that light. It is manifest. The light is reflected. That itself is the manifestation of the sunlight. When any object blocks that sunlight, it bounces off and you see, but what you are seeing is not the Vishaya really. What you are seeing is the sun rays bouncing off the Vishaya, any light. Similarly, is the Atma manifesting in Vishayas. Ayam eva samichina siddhanta, says the Guru. This itself is the right siddhanta. Yadi asti atra te samshayaha tava. For you, if there is any samshaya, te samshaya asti chet. Nirvyalikam eva pritcha. Ask without holding back. That is the idea there. Bhavartha is without holding back, ask. Because you should not hold on to doubts. They'll become drada and they won't go. Unless the doubts go away, there is no moksha possibility. Punas susputam evatvam bodhayeyam iti guru raha. He makes a commitment. I am committed to get your doubts cleared. So susputam, again I'll teach. No issues. Whatever you ask, I'll try to explain clearly. bodhayeyam, I would clearly explain so that jnana is avagati paryantam. Till you get it, I'll teach, says the guru. Jnanina api visheshu iccha. Vishaya sambandhat atmananda avabhasascha bhavati nava iti tattvadrishti prachyati. So tattvadrishti asks as to whether jnani also has this vishaya iccha. And this ananda avabhana, which is said, avabhasa, is it there for a jnani also due to vishaya sambandha? That is a question. Because once you know jnani lakshana, jnani, then you can understand what is it in reality. You know how ajnas behavior is, how it works, we know generally. At least this tattva drishti being an uttama adhikari, he knows. Hey Sadguru, he asks, oh Sadguru, vishaya sambandhad atmananda avabhasa kramaha ajnani vishaye pratipadito bhavadbhi. By you, the Sadguru, what has been explained is Vishaya Sambandhad. Due to Vishaya Sambandhad, there is Ananda. That Ananda is Atmananda itself. And the Krama for that has been explained by you. That is, in which case, Ajnani Vishaye. What has been Pratipadita, what has been taught, revealed by you is Ajnani Vishaye. In the case of Ajnani. Na jnani vishaye, but in the case of jnani you have not explained. Yato yasya buddhihi atma swarupa vimukha tam adhikritya prastava kritav purvam bhavadbihi. Why so? Because initially you had said that buddhi becomes chanchala, atma swarupa vimukha, it goes away from the, because krama has been taught, krama has been revealed as to how is the vishaya ananda. The ananda, any ananda really, taking the example, vishaya, vishaya ananda, visheshu ananda bhavati vanava, he says no. Then the, what has been said, actually vishaya is not discussed. The krama, in the krama, guru said that you don't need to seek anymore. Whatever ananda, moksha ananda you are seeking, you are already that. Then he says it cannot be my swarupa ananda. Why? Tattva drishti, as a shishya, he says, my atma ananda cannot be true, as in ananda cannot be the swarupa of atma, because I have vishaya ananda anubhava. It manifests when I have vishaya sambandha. There it was said that visheshu ananda nasti eva. Why? Because the ananda which is manifest is the atmananda. In the krama, it was said that the kama vishaya iccha takes away oneself from oneself, as though, and then there is dukkha due to separation, the separation, mithya separation from one's own swarupa ananda. One is separated from the ananda, and that iccha taking one away, there is dukkha. Once the vishaya anubhava takes place, that iccha drops off, and then the chanchala buddhi becomes sthira, sthiri bhavati. So buddhi atma swarupa vimukha, which was said due to vishaya iccha, tamadi krutya. Based on that, prastava krita, what has been explained, it is based on that. Purvam bhavadbhi, earlier what has been taught by you. Tadrushascha ajnani eva na jnani. So bhavadbhi, this is in language, sometimes it is used the third person. Now it is very common in spoken language, although it is used very rarely. Should be used very rarely. This bhavan, bhavati, bhavadbhi, all this is kind of alien to Sanskrit, really. It is not so common. There is a lot of influence of the other languages. There is nothing wrong in addressing the second person. In fact, this is Vyakrana Viruddha. Vyakrana Shastra says that when Yushmat Shabda is being used as a replacement for Yushmat Shabda, also you cannot bring in anything else. When Yushmat is there, then only the second person should be used. Madhyama Purusha. Yushmadi Madhyama Purusha. But here you see Prathama Purusha has been used. Bhavan is a third person. But it is culturally, traditionally, when you talk to a king or a guru, it's treated as you generally don't address directly. That is cultural, but it is not used often. It is should be rarely used. It should not be used for every Tom, Dick, and Harry generally. But then it is easier that way. That's why people use it. Madhyama Purusha, you can avoid. That's how the spoken language is. To train the people, they use this, and then it sets in. It never goes away. So everyone addresses each and everyone as Bhavan or Bhavati. Whereas it should be you. Direct address is you. You are talking to someone and you talk as third person. It in any other language, it would seem very odd. And it is odd because it is not meant to be so. Only in some cases. So, Krutaha Purvam Bhavadbhi. If you literally translate it, here if you add a verb, it will be third person. It will not be second person. But then in understanding, we said it was explained by you. But this Bhavadbhi, by you, there is no meaning as by you there. There is by him. It will be by him, by the respected sir, really. That's how it means. Tadrushascha ajnani evana jnani. So one who has his buddhi, which is atma swarupa vimukha, gone away from one's own swarupa, that is tadrusha, that kind of a person whose buddhi is turned around is an ajnani, not jnani. Therefore, what he explained is tamadikritya. That kind of person, yasya buddhihi vimukha bhavati tam adhikrutya sa ajnani eva bhavati bhavitum arhati natu jnani tasmad idanim jnaninu api vishe vishu iccha. Now my question is very specific, whether for a jnani also vishe iccha is there, and vishe sambandha is tasya api jnaninaha vishe sambandhat purvokta kramena sukhabhi vyaptischa jayatenava iti bodhayitum arahanti bhavantaha iti. So you, the respected sir, should tell me. What should you tell me? Whether jnani also has this sukhabhi vyaktihi. Does he have the manifestation of sukha due to vishaya sambandha? Just as you explained purokta kramena in the sequence that you explained in the case of an ajnani. Please reveal this. Please teach me that idea. See, says the shishya tattva drishti. So the guru is answering now. Vyavahara kale jnani api atma vimukha eva. When there is vyavahara, then the guru is the jnani also is turned away from atma. Otherwise, vyavahara is not possible. But there is a catch. There is a difference which we will see in the teaching here. Saha vishyanandasya swarupanandad abhinnatam manyate. Saha Vishayanandasya Swarupa Anandat. From the Swarupa Ananda, he does not consider Abhinnatam. He considers non-difference between Vishayananda and Swarupa Ananda. So Vishayananda is nothing but manifest Swarupa Ananda. This the Jnani knows, but the Ajnani does not. Ajnani is really craving for Vishayananda because he has Vishaya Iccha. Jnani is interacting the Vishaya without the Vishaya Iccha. There may be some. Now this, when Jnani said that, there is a gradations in Jnanis. Based on the gradations of the Jnanis, during the interaction, there may be Vishaya Iccha or followed by Vishaya Iccha. In the higher cases, highest case, there may not be of the Jnani. In the gradation of the Jnani, based on his Prarabdha, based on the Vasana Lesha, there may or may not be Vishaya Iccha. In the highest case, there won't be Vishaya Iccha, but then there is an interaction because he is living in the body, and then the body has interaction. Guna Guneshu Vartante. The Jnani goes along, facilitates that Prarabdha interaction, but then he himself is free from the desire there. But then there is Ananda manifestation also. Because of Vishaya Sambandha, there will be Ananda because Vishaya will go away, drop away. In fact, the Ananda is always there for the Jnani. When he's turned around, that time a little bit, you know, interaction may take away some Ananda manifestation, which will come back after the Vishaya interaction is over. So, hey Shishya, Shrunu Savadana Manaha. This is a Bahuri. Savadhanam Manaha. Yasya saha savadhana manaha. Prathama ekvachana. It is not plural. It is sakaranta manas shabda. ending with manas shabda and manas being neuter when it becomes pullinga in a bahuri for shishya tattva drishti then it will become savadana manaha so please listen o shrunu so shrunu savadana manaha or it can be sambodhana also but savadana mana either way it is prathama vibhakti that's prathama vibhakti and ekavachana that is the importance here o you listen how savadana manaha sun we should not say santa here it is not plural savadana manaha sun shrunu so you listen being one who has an attentive mind because this is important says the guru to the shishya everything is important but this is basically to draw attention it is a way to address we see that in Gita many a time yaduktam atmaswarupa vaimukhyam eva visheichhadi karanam iti what was already said earlier as the visheichhadi karanam as what yaduktam atmaswarupa vaimukhyam eva visheichhadi karanam iti they go hand in hand going outward from one's own swarupa and visheichha they have a dependency they go hand in hand so when you say you see atma swarupa vaimukhyam then it has to be due to visheichha or it is for the visheichha and or visheichha will take away one from atma swarupa vaimukhyam both ways it is possible here evakara is added here it can go here as well so vishaya ichchadi karanam is what atma swarupa vaimukhyam tanna kevalam ajnyasya eva kintu jnanino api tulyam eva tat it is same in the case of jnani also it is not something which is specific for the ajnani jnani cha yada vyavahare pravartate tada sa tattva vismarana purvakam eva pravartate then when jnani also interacts with the world outside then tattva vismarana purvakam eva pravartate he has to let go of the tattva has to or the tattva is let gone one's own swarupa is let gone and then he has an interaction with the vishayas thereby it is common between a jnani and ajnani there is a tippana on a long tippana in fact on that vismarana what is this vismarana tattva vismarana how is it possible for jnani that is explained by the tippana kara here jagrata akara vrutyudbhave na swapna akara vruttir jayate when one is waking that time one will not have swapna vritti the swapna prapancha no longer exists for one who has woken up from the dream and when one who has gone from waking to dream swapna akara vrutyudbhave cha na jagrata akara vruttir jayate if one is waking but then suddenly falls asleep and dreams then the waking world is not seen so waking world and the dream world are never yugapat they are not together if you are waking you are not dreaming if you are dreaming you are not waking evam eva jnanino buddhihi yada atmakara bhavati tada na anatmakara bhavati when there is an atmakara vritti then it cannot be anatmakara vritti jagadakara vritti won't be there jagat being idamakara there won't be any idam or jagadakara vritti ghatakara patakara vritti won't be there when it is atmakara vritti for a jnani and when there is jagadakara idamakara anatmakara yada anatmakara tada na atmakara bhavati you can have only atmakara vritti or anatmakara vritti you cannot have both together in fact you cannot have anatmakara as in ghatakara vritti and patakara vritti together you cannot have shabdakara vritti and rupakara vritti together no two vrittis no specific vrittis no visheshakara vrittis can be together there can be samanyakara vritti and visheshakara vritti together because what underlying principle is in the vritti is that aham ghatam janami or this ghatakara vritti when it takes place Or let's take in the case of mithya, it will be more clear. When one says this is a pot, when one says there is a ghatakara vritti, then ayam ghataha, that is the vritti. Not ghatamaham janami, let's say ayam ghataha. This is the vritti in ghatakara vritti. When there is a rajju sarpakara vritti, then iyam rajjuhu, that iyam rajjuhu is not seen. What is the akara of the vritti there? Sarpakara vritti. But the rajju is in the front. So iyam sarp, this iyam rajjuhu, in that iyam rajju, iyam ausha, which is the idam ausha, only this is known, whereas rajju is not known. So samanyataya idam vritti is known, but then vishesha rajju is not known, vishesha sarpa is known. That is a bhranti. We'll land there. Next, we'll land how this bhranti takes place. But in the case of bhranti, you can see the samanya and vishesha ausha are different. In ayam ghataha, it is not seen. But ayam is a samanya ansha and ghataha is a vishesha ansha. In the case of bhranti, ayam or iyam, in the case of the rajju sarpa, rajju is strilinga, therefore iyam. Iyam ansha, which is actually idam, general case will take neuter, samanya napunsakalingam, there idam ansha is samanya ansha, whereas the sarpa ansha is vishesha ansha. They can go together, but you cannot have ghata and pata, which are both ayam ghataha, ayam pataha. This ghata vritti and pata vritti cannot go together. Idam vritti and ghata vritti, idam vritti and pata vritti, idam vritti and rajju vritti, idam vritti and sarpa vritti can go together, but you cannot have two visheshas together. So Atmakara vritti is a Vishesha vritti, Anatmakara vritti is also Vishesha vritti. You cannot have two Anatmakara vrittis simultaneously, nor can you have Atmakara vritti and Anatmakara vritti simultaneously. Yadyapi eka antakkarana adhikaranaka bhinna vishayaka samanya vishesha rupa vrittidvayam yugapat jayeta, tathapi vishesha rupa vrittidvayam tu naiva jayeta. So that is what I explained now. As to the samanya, which is what antakkarana adhikaranaka. Antakkarana is one. In one antakkarana, how can you have two vrittis simultaneously? It is said all vrittis that seem to be simultaneous also are sequential. Because Atma, which has a reflection in the antakkarana and the vrittis which are reflected there, they cannot be simultaneous. There cannot be a connection that way. But samanya adhikarana, this antakkarana, which is adhikarana for all vrittis, eka antakkarana adhikarana, adhikaranaka, in that adhikarana, bhinna vishayaka. There are two different vishayas. Bhinna will take only two right now. Which are those? Samanya and vishesha. Those kind of samanya rupa vritti and vishesha rupa vritti dvayam. Two vrittis, yugapat jayeta, yatyapi. Even though it is possible that both samanya and vishesha are simultaneous, still, tathapi, in the eka antakkarana, in the same antakkarana nishta, in that antakkarana, there are two simultaneous vrittis, one being samanya, other vishesha, one idamamsha and the other vishayamsha, tathapi, vishaya namarupamsha, tathapi, vishesha rupa vrittidvayam tu naiva jayeta. There cannot be two visheshas. That is what we saw earlier. Yatha vyavaharantarasaktah purushaha petikasthadhanam hastena sprushannapi nasmarati tadhanam vyavaharavasane tu tadhanam smarati evameva. So example is given similar to what he gives another example, how example which will make it clear how this vritti cannot be Vishesha vrittis cannot be simultaneous. Yatha vyavaharantarasaktah purusha. A person who is engaged in another vishay, another vyavahara. Let's say somebody is counting money. This person is counting money. Consider a vaishya, a businessman, a merchant who is sitting at the counter where the interaction is of money. and he is counting money in the petika, in the drawer. He has money and he is counting that, and while counting he is talking to someone. The hands are moving the money to count, and he'll definitely lose count. He is talking to the other person, he's, you know, engaged in some other activity, then he loses count of the money, because that counting money is vishesha, the interaction with other is vishesha, both are to, cannot be done simultaneously, because in antakarana there can be only that other vyavahara vritti or the dhana counting vritti. Samanya and vishesha can be together, two visheshas cannot be together. What will happen is that when he is counting, yatha vyavahara antarasakta purusha petikasta dhanam hastena sprushanapi, even when he is touching that money. In fact, here example is not about counting, although I said it is counting. It is example here in the tippana is only about touching the, he does not even know that dhana is in his hand, because he is interacting. It is even more basic than counting. Does not even know that he is touching the money. Hastena sprushanapi na smarati tad dhanam, because this sparsha vritti, dhana sparsha vritti, and the other vyavahara, vyavaharanta vritti, sorry, cannot be simultaneous. But at the end of that vyavahara, the second activity that he is doing, other than the dhana sparsha, vyavahara avasanitu tad dhanam smarati, the coins that he is holding in his hand, they are clear to him. Oh, I have these coins in my hand. That is what I was doing. Vyavahara avasani. When the earlier, the second vyavahara ends, then the first vyavahara comes back to the antakkarana, to taddhanam smarati. He recalls that I have, now he understands that there is a sparsha vritti, and then there is a recall of what he was doing earlier. Evam eva jnani api vyavahara dashayam yada vishyabhimukhav bhavati tadatasya tattva vismaranam bhavati. So what is this tattva vismaranam in the mula? It is very similar to the example given of a person holding dhana in his hand but talking to someone or interacting in something else, does not even remember that he is carrying money, has dhana in his hand, but as soon as that vyavahara ends, he has to do nothing. He has to do nothing because his, the dhana sparsha is already there, not known, not manifest during the other interaction. It is not lost on him. In the case of Ajnani, he does not have dhanasparsha at all. He does not have atmasparsha, so to say. Atmadarshana is lacking for an Ajnani. For a Jnani, atmadarshana is there. And on top of that, there is a vyavahara. Then that atmadarshana vritti is not possible simultaneously because of that atmakara vritti being vishesha vritti, and the anatmakara vritti being another vishaya vritti, which has replaced it now. But as soon as that anatmakara vyavahara vritti ceases to be, then that vishayakara vritti ceasing, the atmadarshana vritti, atmakara vritti comes back again, and that is said to be vismaranam during the interaction with the vishaya. So that is tattva vismaranam. एवमेव ज्ञानी अपि व्यवहार दशायां यदा विषयाभिमुखो भवति, दिस इज द अनात्माकार वृत्ति, देन तदा दैट टाइम तस्य तत्व विस्मरण भवति, दिस इज आत्माकार वृत्ति विस्मरण, आत्माकार वृत्ति नॉट टेकिंग प्लेस, आत्म विस्मरण एज दो, बिकॉज इट इज स्टिल देयर अंडरलाइन विच इज नॉट देयर इन द केस ऑफ द अज्ञानी, दिस इज द डिफरेंस. व्यवहार समाप्तो पुनरपि तत्वनिष्ठ एव स भवति, एज सून एज व्यवहार एंड्स, automatically he has atmakara vritti. There is no effort on his part anymore. In fact, in vyavahara there is effort, but in atmanishta, tattvanishta, there is no tattvanishta, there is no effort. This is bauri tattve nishthayasya sa tattvanishtaha. Jnani is tattvanishtaha at the end of the vyavahara. Ata eva uktam bhashyakarahi. This is what we saw a couple of days back, couple of classes back maybe. Ata eva uktam bhashyakarahi. Bhagwan Bhashyakara has said so. It has been said by him. Shri Bhagwat Puja Padaihi Bhashyakarahi evam uktam eva. Ata eva uktam. Therefore it is said by Bhagwan Bhashyakara अध्यास प्रकरण इन अध्यास भाष्य इट इज सेड पश्वादिभिश्चा विशेषात द बिहेवियर ऑफ ज्ञानी ऑल्सो ह्यूमन बीइंग्स ऑल्सो वेर ह्यूमन बीइंग्स इंक्लूड ज्ञानी एंड अज्ञानी बोथ आर लाइक द बिहेवियर इज पश्वादिविश्च अविशेष मीन समान द वे इज द बिहेवियर ऑफ पशु सिमिलरली इज द बिहेवियर ऑफ अ ह्यूमन बीइंग वेदर ज्ञानी और अज्ञानी व्यवहार काले अतः समान पशुआदि भी सो अविशेष इज वॉट समान पशुआदि भी समान पुरुषाण प्रमाण प्रमेय व्यवहार इन व्यवहार काला देर इज प्रमाण नीडेड विच आर इंद्रिया देर इज प्रमेय वस्तु विषय दैट विषय एंड विषय इंद्रिय संबंध इज देर इंद्रिया संबंध इज देर एंड आनंद मे बी ड्यू टू दैट आनंद मे बी ड्यू टू दैट मीन्स फॉर अज्ञानी आनंद इज thought to be erroneously due to that but really it is atmananda this the jnani knows but the ajnani doesn't iti that is the comment on the moola here vismaranam tattva vismarana purvakamya pravartate so let's just read this sentence and stop here jnani cha yada vyavahare pravartate tada saha tattva vismarana purvakamya pravartate this is important That's why Shrunu Savadana Manaha San. We'll stop here. We'll continue from the next line in the next part. Sukan Nityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Namarupayo Adhishtanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddhyer Drukyatya Nirmana Aparam Sarvavedanta Vedyam Pratyak Paramaha Tadeva Hanumattvanya Diti Me Shitamatihi Sat. We'll see you in the next part. Namaste.
Hariyam.